by the guide on the Code of Criminal Procedure. Question: what is the name of the act and when it has been come into force? Answer: as per section 1, subsection 1 of the Code of Criminal Procedure, this act may be called the Code of Criminal Procedure 1898, and it came into force on the first day of July 1898. Question: what is the definition of advocate? Answer: as per the section 4, subsection 1A of the Code of Criminal Procedure, advocate used with reference to any proceeding in any court means an advocate or a mukhtar authorized under any law for the time being in force to practice in any court, and includes any other person appointed with the permission of the court to act in such proceeding. Question: what is bailable offense and non-bailable offense? Answer: as per the section 4, subsection 1B of the Code of Criminal Procedure, bailable offense means an offense shown as bailable in the second schedule or which is made bailable by any other law for the time being in force, and non-bailable offense means any other offense. Question: what is cognizable offense and cognizable case? Answer: as per the section 4, subsection 1F of the Code of Criminal Procedure, cognizable offense means an offense for, and cognizable case means a case in which a police officer may, in accordance with the second schedule or under any law for the time being in force, arrest without warrant. Question: what is a complaint? Answer: as per the section 4, subsection 1H of the Code of Criminal Procedure, complaint means the allegation made orally or in writing to a magistrate with a view to his taking action under this court, that some person has, whether known or unknown, has committed an offense, but it does not include the report of a police officer. Question: what is inquiry? Answer: as per the section 4, subsection 1K of the Code of Criminal Procedure, inquiry includes every inquiry other than a trial conducted under this court by a magistrate or court. Question: what is investigation? Answer: as per the section 4, subsection 1L of the Code of Criminal Procedure, investigation includes all the proceedings under this code for the collection of evidence conducted by a police officer or by any person who is authorized by magistrate in this behalf. Question: what is non-cognizable offense and non-cognizable case? Answer: as per the section 4, subsection 1N of the Code of Criminal Procedure, non-cognizable offense means an offense for, and non-cognizable of a case means a case in which a police officer may not arrest without a warrant. What is offense? Answer: as per the section 4, subsection 1O of the Code of Criminal Procedure, offense means any act or omission made punishable by any law for the time being in force. Question: describe the classes of criminal courts. Answer: according to section 6, subsection 1 of the Code of Criminal Procedure, besides the Supreme Court and the courts constituted under any law for the time being in force other than this court, there shall be two classes of criminal courts in Bangladesh, namely number A, courts of sessions, and number B, courts of magistrate. Number two, there shall be two classes of magistrate, namely number A, judicial magistrate, and number B, executive magistrate. Number three, there shall be four classes of judicial magistrate, namely number A, chief metropolitan magistrate in metropolitan area, and chief judicial magistrate to other areas. Number B, magistrate of the first class, who shall in metropolitan area, is known as metropolitan magistrate. Number C, magistrate of the second class, and number D, magistrate of the third class. Question: narrate the Court of Sessions. Answer: according to section 9, subsection 1 of the Code of Criminal Procedure, The government shall establish a court of session for every sessions division and appoint a judge of such court. And the court of sessions for metropolitan area shall be called the metropolitan court of sessions. Number question, a narrate executive magistrate. Answer, according to section 10 subsection 1 of the code of criminal procedure, in every district and in every metropolitan area, the government shall appoint as many persons as it thinks fit to be executive magistrate and shall appoint one of them to be the district magistrate. Question, narrate judicial magistrate. Answer, according to section 11 subsection 1 of the code of criminal procedure, in every district outside metropolitan area, the chief judicial magistrate, additional chief judicial magistrate and other judicial magistrates shall be appointed from the persons employed in the Bangladesh judicial service. Question, narrate metropolitan magistrate. Answer, according to section 18 subsection 1 of the code of criminal procedure, in every metropolitan area, the chief metropolitan magistrate, additional chief metropolitan magistrate and other metropolitan magistrates shall be appointed from the persons employed in the Bangladesh judicial service. Question, define arrest. Answer, according to section 46 subsection 1 of the code of criminal procedure, in making an arrest, the police officer or other person making the same shall actually touch or confine the body of the person to be arrested unless there be submission to the custody by word or action. Question, when police can arrest without warrant? Answer, according to section 54 subsection 1 of the code of criminal procedure, any police officer may, without an order from a magistrate or without a warrant, arrest unless there be submission to the custody by word or action. Question, how long the person arrested can be detained by police? Answer, according to section 61 of the code of criminal procedure, no police officer shall detain in custody a person arrested without warrant for a longer period than under all circumstances of the case is reasonable, and such period shall not, in the absence of a special order of a magistrate, exceed 24 hours, exclusive of the time necessary for the journey from the place of arrest to the magistrate's court. Question, narrate the search procedure for persons wrongfully confined. Answer, section 100 of the code of criminal procedure, if any metropolitan magistrate of the first class or an executive magistrate has reason to believe that any person is confined under such circumstances that the confinement amounts to an offense, he may issue a search warrant, and the person to whom such warrant is directed may search for the person so confined, and such search may be made in accordance therewith, and the person, if found, shall be immediately taken before a magistrate who shall make such order as in the circumstances of the case seems proper. Question, how search to be made? Answer, according to section 103 subsection 1 of the code of criminal procedure, before making a search under this chapter, the officer or the other person about to make it shall call upon two or more respectable inhabitants of the locality in which the place to be searched is situated to attend and witness the search, and may issue an order in writing to them or any of them to do. Question, narrate information of cognizable cases. Answer, as per the section 154 of the code of criminal procedure, every information relating to the commission of a cognizable offense, if given orally to a to an officer in charge of a police station shall be reduced to writing by him or under his direction and be read over to the informant, and every such information, whether given in writing of or reduced to writing as aforesaid, shall be signed by the person giving it, and the substance thereof shall be entered in a book to be kept by such officer in such form as the government may prescribe in this behalf. Question: narrate information of non-cognizable offense. Answer: as per the section 155, subsection 1 of the Code of Criminal Procedure, when information is given to a officer, to an officer in charge of a police station of the commission within the limits of such station of a non-cognizable offense, he shall enter in a book to be kept as aforesaid the substance of such information and refer the informant to the magistrate. Question: narrate the power of a police officer to require attendance of witness. Answer: as per the section 160 of the Code of Criminal Procedure, any police officer making an investigation under this chapter may, by order in writing, require the attendance before himself or any person being within the limits of his own or any adjoining station who, from the information given or otherwise, appears to be acquainted with the circumstances of the case, and such person shall attend as so required. Question: discuss police report. Answer: section 173, subsection 1 of the Code of Criminal Procedure, every investigation under this chapter shall be completed without unnecessary delay, and as soon as it is completed, the officer in charge of the police station shall, number A, forward to a magistrate empowered to take cognizance the offense on a police report, a report in the form prescribed by the government, as setting forth the name of the parties, the nature of information, and the name of the persons who appears to be acquainted with the circumstances of the case, and stating whether the accused, if arrested, has been forwarded in the custody or has been released on his bond, and if so, whether with or without sureties. Question: narrate the procedure of taking cognizance of offense by magistrates. Answer: as per the section 190, subsection 1 of the Code of Criminal Procedure, any chief metropolitan magistrate, chief judicial magistrate, magistrate of the first class, and any other magistrate specially empowered in this behalf may take cognizance, number A, upon receiving a complaint of facts which constitute such offense, number B, upon report in writing of such facts made by any police officer, number C, upon information received from any other person other than a police officer, or upon his own knowledge or suspicion that such offense has been committed. Question: narrate the procedure of examination of complainant. Answer: according to section 200 of the Code of Criminal Procedure, a magistrate taking cognizance of an offense on complaint shall at once examine upon oath the complainant and such of the witnesses present, if any, as he may consider necessary, and the substance of the examination shall be reduced to writing and shall be signed by the complainant or witnesses so examined and by the magistrate. Question: when accused shall be discharged by the magistrate? Answer: section 241 A of the Code of Criminal Procedure. I repeat it, section 241 A of the Code of Criminal Procedure. When the accused appears or is brought before the magistrate, and if the magistrate, upon consideration of the record of the case and the documents submitted therewith, and making such examination, if any, of the accused as the magistrate thinks necessary, and after giving the prosecution and the accused an opportunity of being heard, considers the charge to be groundless, he shall discharge the accused and record his reasons for so doing. Question: when accused will get acquainted by the magistrate? Answer: according to section 245 of the Code of Criminal Procedure, if the magistrate, upon taking the evidence referred to in section 244, and such further evidence, if any, as he may of his own motion, came to be produced, and if he thinks fit, examining the accused, finds the accused not guilty, he shall record an order of acquittal. Question: what is the duty of the complainant does not appear not appear before the magistrate? I repeat the question: what is the duty if the complainant does not appear before the magistrate? Answer: according to section 247 of the Code of Criminal Procedure, if the summons has been issued on the complaint or the complainant, and upon the day, if the summons has been issued on complaint and upon the day appointed for the appearance of the accused, or any day subsequent thereto, which the hearing may be adjourned, the complainant does not appear, the magistrate shall, notwithstanding anything herein before contained, acquit the accused, unless for some reason he thinks proper to adjourn the hearing of the case to some other day. Question: describe the procedure of stopping proceedings by magistrate. As per section 249 of the Code of Criminal Procedure, in any case instituted otherwise than upon complaint, a metropolitan magistrate, a magistrate of the first class, or with the previous sanction of the chief judicial magistrate, any other judicial magistrate, may not for reasons to be recorded by him, stop the proceedings at any stage without pronouncing any judgment, either of acquittal or conviction, and may thereupon release the accused. Question: who starts the trial before the court of sessions? Answer: as per the section 265A of the Code of Criminal Procedure, in every trial before a court of sessions, the prosecution shall be conducted by a public prosecutor. Question: narrate discharge by the court of sessions. Answer: section 265C of the Code of Criminal Procedure, if upon consideration of the record of the case and the documents, and after hearing the accused and the prosecution in this behalf, and the court considers that there is no sufficient ground for proceeding against the accused, it shall discharge the accused and record the reason for so doing. Question: describe charge frame procedure by court of sessions. Answer: section 265D 1, subsection 1 of the Code of Criminal Procedure, if after such consideration and hearing as aforesaid, the court is of opinion that there is ground for presuming that the accused has committed an offense, it shall frame in writing a charge against the accused. Question: describe acquittal by the court of sessions. Answer: section 265H of the Code of Criminal Procedure, if after taking the evidence for the prosecution, examining the accused and hearing the prosecution and the defense on the point, the court considers that there is no evidence that the accused committed the offense, the court shall record an order of acquittal. Question: describe the appeal procedure from sentence of joint session judge and magistrate of the first class. Answer: Section 408 of the Code of Criminal Procedure. Any person convicted on a trial held by a joint session judge, metropolitan magistrate, or any judicial magistrate of the first class may appeal to the session judge, provided as follows. Number A, when in any case a joint session judge passes any sentence of imprisonment of a term exceeding 5 years, the appeal of all or any of the convicted persons shall lie to the High Court Division. Number B, when any person is convicted by a metropolitan magistrate or judicial magistrate specially empowered to try an offense under Section 124A of the Penal Code, the appeal shall lie to the High Court Division. Question: describe the powers to call for records from inferior courts. Answer: Section 435, subsection 1 of the Code of Criminal Procedure. The High Court Division or any sessions judge may call for and examine the record of any proceedings before any inferior criminal court situated within the local limits of its or his jurisdiction for the purpose of satisfying itself or himself as to the correctness, legality, or propriety of any finding, sentence, or order recorded or passed, and as to the regularity of any proceeding of such inferior court, and may, when calling for such record, direct that the execution of any sentence be suspended, and if the accused is in confinement, that he be released on bail or on his own bond pending the examination of the record. Question: describe the revision power of the High Court Division. Answer: Section 439, subsection 1 of the Code of Criminal Procedure. In the case of any proceeding, the record of which has been called for by itself or which has been reported for orders or which otherwise comes to its knowledge, the High Court Division may, in its discretion, exercise any of the powers conferred on a court of appeal by sections 423, 426, 427, and 428 of the Code of Criminal Procedure. Question: describe the revision power of the session judges. Answer: Section 439A, subsection 1 of the Code of Criminal Procedure. In the case of any proceeding, the record of which has been called for by himself or which otherwise comes to his knowledge, the session judge may exercise all or any of the powers which may be exercised by the High Court Division under Section 439. Question: describe bail in bailable of cases. Answer: as per the Section 496 of the Code of Criminal Procedure, when any person other than a person accused of non-bailable offense is arrested or detained without warrant by an officer in charge of a police station, or appears or is brought before a court and is prepared at any time while in the custody of such officer or at any stage of the proceeding before such court to give bail, such person shall be released on bail, provided that such officer or court, if he or it thinks fit, may, instead of taking bail from such person, discharge him on his executing a bond without sureties for his appearance as hereinafter provided. Question: when bail will grant in case of non-bailable offense? Answer: according to Section 497 of the Code of Criminal Procedure, when in person accused of any non-bailable offense is arrested for detailed procedure, criminal procedure, when any person accused of any non-bailable offense is arrested or detained without warrant by an officer in charge of a police station or appears or is brought before a court, he may be released on bail, but he shall not be so released if there appears reasonable grounds for believing that he has been guilty of an offense punishable with death or transportation for life, provided that the court may direct that any person under the age of 16 years or any woman or any sick or infirm person accused of such an offense be released on bail. Question: describe inherent powers of the High Court Division. Answer: Section 561A of the Code of Criminal Procedure, nothing in this code shall be deemed to limit or affect the inherent power of the High Court Division to make such orders as may be necessary to give effect to any order under this code, and to prevent abuse of the process of the court or otherwise to secure the ends of justice. Question: what are the criminal jurisdiction of the High Court Division? Answer: Number 1, criminal appellate jurisdiction. Number 2, criminal revisional jurisdiction. Number 3, criminal miscellaneous jurisdiction. Number 4, criminal reference jurisdiction. Criminal appeal. Appeal section under section 14 of the Code of Criminal Procedure, appeal from the sentence of sessions and additional session judge. Appeal under section 408 of the Code of Criminal Procedure, when conviction above 5 years, appeal to be filed in the High Court Division. Appeal under section 420 of the Code of Criminal Procedure, jail appeal. If the appellant is in jail, he may present his petition of appeal through the officer in charge of the jail. This called jail appeal. Appeal under special laws, that is under section 30 of the Special Powers Act 1974, Exclusive Substance Act, Arms Act 1878. Appeal under section 28 of the Nario Shishu Nirjaton Damon Act 2000. Any judgment or order passed by the Nario Shishu Nirjaton Damon Adalot is always appealable. Question: what is memo of appeal? Answer: section 419 of the Code of Criminal Procedure lays down that every appeal shall be made in the form of a petition in writing presented by the appellant or his advocate, and every such petition is called memo of appeal. Question: what is the limitation period for criminal appeal? Answer: as per Article 150 of the Limitation Act, death sentence, the time limit is 7 days from the date of sentence. And as Article 155, the same act for other criminal appeal, limitation period is 60 days. Question: what is appeal under special law? Answer: appeal from the order or judgment of a Nario Shishu Nirjaton Damon Tribunal shall have to file under section 28 of the Nario Shishu Nirjaton Damon Act 2000 before the Honorable High Court Division. Appeal from the order or judgment of a special tribunal shall have to file under section 30 of the Special Powers Act 1974 before the Honorable High Court Division. Appeal from the order or judgment of a special judge shall have to file under section 10 of the Criminal Law Amendment Act 1958 before the Honorable High Court Division. Question: what is criminal revision? The main provision of the criminal revision is section 439 and 435 of the Code of Criminal Procedure. Where there has been an appeal in the lower court against an order or judgment of the trial court, and that appeal is rejected or dismissed by the lower appellate court, the criminal to be filed before the High Court Division. Where there is no provision of appeal from order or judgment of the session or additional session judge, criminal revision under section 439 will lie. What is limitation period of criminal revision? Answer: nothing is mentioned with regard to period of limitation for criminal revision in the Limitation Act. In the case Khadim Ali versus State, the Honorable High Court Division decided that limitation period is 60 days for filing criminal revision. Question: what are criminal miscellaneous? Answer: bail petition, anticipatory bail petition, and regular bail petition under section 498 of the Code of Criminal Procedure. Transferring a case from one court to another court under section 426 of the Code of Criminal Procedure. Habeas corpus petition under section 491 of the Code of Criminal Procedure. Application for contempt of court. Quashment petition under section 461A of the Code of Criminal Procedure are filed under miscellaneous jurisdiction. If the conviction has been given in a special law, no appeal shall be preferred, and the time for appeal has expired, there must go for 561A. Conviction has been given under a special law, appeal was preferred under, but the same is rejected, trial in absentia can be a good ground for 561A application.